My first impressions of the lens were, wow, this is impressive. The finish quality, rubber rings, and the fact that it is 18 to 135, which gives you great capability, impressed me right away. So let's talk about that. The rubberized focus and magnification rings are easy to turn, but the focus ring is specifically much easier than the magnification rings, and you can literally turn it with one finger. The finish of the lens itself is nice to the touch. You do get good quality images and videos. It has an AF and MF switch on the side, which will free up an additional shortcut button on your camera. It has excellent automatic focus and performance, and that's expected as it is a native Sony lens. Of course, we get optical steady shot here, and that helps a lot when you're doing a lot of handheld filming or photography. 18 to 135 millimeter focal length is an excellent range, which allows you to do a lot of different work, portraits, landscapes, vlogging, and much more. We do get a pretty high aperture number, ranging from 3.5 to 5.6, which will limit us in low light situations, and making a blurry background will be more challenging. It's important to note that the body extends when you are zooming, so it is a factor, especially when trying to balance it on the gimbal. And lastly, the front glass element is quite large, so I would suggest getting a quality UV filter. Overall, this lens is a good performer with a premium feel and is one of the lightest APS-C zoom lenses from Sony. Keep an eye on video thumbnails if you want to see more footage with this lens. If you find this content useful, give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel to support future content. Until next time.